Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the rear wall and how rude it is in our presentations and audio rooms. So let's kind of back up a little bit and deal with what kind of energy strikes the rear wall. We have our direct energy, and that's the energy from our loudspeakers. And that's the purest form of energy we can have at the listening position, because that doesn't include any of the room sound. Then, of course, we have the reflected energy from the speakers, and that is all about room sound. So there's management of the reflections. There's a balancing act between reflections and direct energy. So it's a complicated process. We have time signatures that we have to keep in mind here, depending on usage. So all of this energy from our speaker then strikes our rear wall, and the rear wall then turns into a really large radiating surface area, okay? Well, we know from our definition of sound, and it travels at a constant speed, so when it strikes that rear wall, it's going to come back and it's going to wash over and mix with both the direct energy from our speakers and the reflected energy in the room. So we have this multiplicity of issues going on here. So we have to be very, very careful about this rear wall. And depending on the usage, and let's just take a control room, for example. If you have all this reflected energy coming back at the listening or monitoring position, it's going to be time delayed, just like the reflections are off the sidewalls. But we have so much more surface area here, and it's more of a direct alignment, so to speak, and influences the direct energy from our speakers more, that we have to be very cognizant of that at the mix and monitoring position. So we have to be really careful with this time delayed signature in our control room so that we don't hear it and incorporate it into our mixes. A lot of engineers call it slapback. You've heard the term slapback echo. Not that accurate in terms, but the slapback part is. So what they're saying is it's a time delayed energy field from that rear wall that washes over. And there's something about that time delayed signature washing over the back of our hearing mechanism in our ears that can really distort things. And you have to be really careful and balance everything out. If you want to test this, just use absorption or diffusion on your rear wall. If you don't have any treatment right now, put some absorption and put some diffusion on the rear wall and test it. And you'll find out just how large of an impact this surface area has. So let's be careful of our rear wall rudeness, so to speak, and manage it correctly. Thank you. Hi, everyone. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it, because I need all that information when we talk. But I'll be happy to accommodate you. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.